So the last one is if, L if, else ladder. Means I can have if the condition is true, else if the condition is true, else if the condition is true, else if the condition is true, and finally else. Fine. So here I can have multiple decisions. Now take an example. If I want to find whether the entered number is a character or a digit or a special character, then I'll check whether it is character. If it is true, it will print it is a character. Else it will again check whether it's a digit. Yeah, if it is digit, then it will print for digit. If it's not a character, if it's not a digit, then definitely it will be a special character. Fine. So let's see what is if else if ladder. Now the condition is if condition, then this statement of the block. If condition, then this block of statement will be executed. If this condition is false, it will go to L if. The next block of code will be executed if this condition is true. Again L if. The next block of code will be executed if it is true. Means till the true condition is found, the condition has skipped. As soon as the true condition is found, that block of statement is executed. But if none of the conditions are true, then there is else condition. So finally there is an else to be executed. So let's see the flowchart. If test condition, block of state, let's see the flowchart. If test condition is true, block 1 will be executed. If that is false, again it will check for the condition. If this condition is true, block 2 of the statement will be executed. If even that is false, it will check for the condition. If that is true, block 3 will be executed. And if none of the blocks are true, then else body block will be executed. So this is how the if elif ladder works. And I've already told you there is no else if, it is elif, elif. So let's see the demonstration of if elif else ladder. Fine. So let's see the demonstration of if elif else ladder. Now here I've declared a variable whose value is 200. Now it is checking if number is 100. No, it's not 100. So it will come to the next condition. If number is equals to 150, so if number is not equal to 150, it will come here. It won't come here because it is not 150. So it will check for if number equal to 200. Yes, number is equals to 200, so it will print number is 200. And if none of the condition is true, it will go to else and it will print number not is not present. So let's execute this program. So see, the number is 200, so this condition is false, 150 condition is false, so this 200 condition is true, that's why it is printing 200. Let's say I'll change the value to 150. Now I'll execute the program. Now see, it is printing number 1 is 150. So I hope all these four branching or the decision statements, that is if, if else, nested if, and if else if ladder is cleared. So let's see the demonstration of if else if else ladder. But here the input is taken from the user and it's being converted into integer. So this is a program which works on number or giving the demonstration of number. So let's execute this program. So see, when I run the program, it is giving me invalid syntax. And see, it is showing the error at colon. But the error is not at colon. Error is here. That is, there is one opening bracket, second opening bracket, but the closing bracket is one. So one closing bracket is missing. Fine, this error is rectified. And now let's execute the program. So it is run. So asking for the number. So let's say I'm entering 100. So it's telling I've given number as 100, so it's giving me number 1 and number 2 is 100, but I'm sorry, there is no number 2, it's only number 1. So again I'll execute the program and I'll enter number as 150. So it is telling me number 1 is between 100 to 200. So number 1 equal to 100 condition becomes false. So it will come to the second condition, number 1 greater than 100 and number 1 less than 200. So this condition becomes true. Why? Because number 1 is greater than 100 and number 2 is greater less than 200. Both the conditions are true. So it satisfied the condition for AND, the logical operator, and it will print number 1 is between 100 and 200. Let's say again I'll execute the program, and this time I'm giving value 250. So same way, this condition is false, this condition is false, but this condition is true. That's why it is printing 200 and 300. And if I give any value which is more than 300, fine. So it is giving me value more than 200. Why? Because my condition is, there is an error over here. So I'll change this, make it 300. And now again, I'll execute the program. So I'll enter the value 350, and see, it is giving number 1 is more than 350 because first condition is false, even this condition is false, even this condition is false, and finally it comes to else, which is the condition without any condition. So it is printing else. So I hope this program is clear. Now we'll see one more program in which I'll decide whether the entire character is a uppercase character or a lowercase character or a digit or a special character. So let's see the another program, that is display the entered character is character number or special character. So very first I have initialized this character to null. So we'll see what happens if I don't define this variable. Fine. Now what happens in my program, it will read the character and it will check whether it is between capital A to Z. Now if it is between capital A to Z, both the conditions will be true. It will print its uppercase character. But if this not is the condition, then it will compare with small a to small z. Again, it is AND condition because both the conditions should be true. So it will print the number is smaller character. Even if this condition is false, it will come to third condition, that is it will check between 0 to 9. Now it will say it is a digit, and if none of the condition is true, it will say it is a special case character. Means it's neither a smaller case, neither upper case, nor a digit, then definitely the remaining things are special character. So let's execute the program. Fine, on execution it is asking me the character. So I'm entering D. So it says it is uppercase character. Now again I'm executing the character. Now this time I'm putting T, which is smaller case. So it says it is a smaller case character. Now again I am executing the program, I am putting 6, so it says it's a digit. And finally I'll say I've entered @, so it says special character. So I hope this program is clear. Fine, this is the last program for the demonstration, but I won't execute this. You will try on your IDE. So here, very first I have initialized the character to null, then I have taken an input a character. Now I am checking if it is A, E, I, O, U, but all are in small case, so I am printing vowel in lowercase character. If that is not a condition, I am checking A, E, I, O, U, and I am printing the vowel in uppercase character. I should print here, vowel in uppercase character. Now see one thing here, I have put OR, means either this or this or this or this or this should be true. So if it is not a uppercase character, not a lowercase character, then what is left? It is a consonant. So it will print consonant. So friends, you will try this program and try such different programs to improve your programming about if else statement or the decision making or the branching statements. So I hope this lecture of branching and decision making is clear to you. You have understood each and everything. But even if is there any difficulty, you can put a comment in the comment box below. And if you really like it, then also put a comment or a suggestion or a feedback, which will really help me to improve and give more better content. So stay safe, stay at home, have a nice time. And my next video is about looping statements in Python.